Hello, my name is Blacc Phoenix, and if you see me on the streets, you can call me Phoenix. This is an outpour of my story. Your booty hoe got more users than IG. Niggas need to quit testing my patience before I make you marriage great patient. Dicking your mouth, so it's fuck what you saying. No, I'm not JC, but yes, I rock patience. Your booty hoe got more users than IG. Stop exposing these DL athletes. Fucking up your point, running your mouth like a track. Need your white heart can still eat this chocolate ass till you get a cavity. Yes, it's nice to meet me. Yes, it's nice. You like that yummy hoe? Okay, so my coming out story, when I was 14 years old, my mother actually caught me in the room, the computer room, masturbating. And so when she came around the corner, it was like 1 o'clock in the morning, she came around the corner into the computer room and she looked in there and was like, what the hell is going on? So she opens up the door and she sees that it's two guys on the screen. And so she just left in like defeat. So she leaves the room and she's like, turn the shit off. You know how like Black mothers do. And so she tightens her lips and she's all like, turn the shit off right now. And so I went to bed thinking I'm about to get my ass whooped when she comes upstairs and, and I'm asleep or something. But no, she was actually really open and accepting of it. She was respectful. She told me about her gay friends that she's had and her experiences that she's had with gay people. And she was very supportive when I came out to her openly, and she didn't have to find it out. I think it was just a lot for her to process when she walked in there on me, you know, masturbating. So that was kind of the shock of that. So that was kind of how I came out to her. How I came out to the entire school, because I was popular in school, and so I felt like once I came out to my mom and my brother, that it was just, all right, tell everybody. So I sent out a mass text to school and I was like, hey, everybody, I'm gay. If you don't like it, it is what it is. And that's it. And I mean, that's how I came out. After that, a couple people sent out messages. It was a huge rumor around the school. And I walked into school the next day and I owned it. I think my mom supporting me is just the biggest relief, because once you told your family, I mean, family is the most important thing to you, so, or at least to me. So once you tell your family, you're just open, you're out, you're free with it, and then now you can just tell everybody else. So I think that once I told my mom and I told my brother, then it's like, oh, okay, I can tell everybody else. Like, everybody else at school, it is what it is. I can tell them. And then like some people were like, oh, is there a list of guys that you like and things like that? So I sent a text message that was like, oh yeah, I think he's cute and things like that. And that was a bad idea, because then of course that text message got out into the entire school. And, but I mean, I own that too. People were like, hey, I saw my name in the text message. I'm like, I think you were cute. I mean, shit, it is what it is. I'm not gonna act on it. And then everybody respected me for just being open and honest, and you know, they treated me like bros. And so that was really all I can ask for. I'm grateful for that story, because I know how it is for other people, and other people aren't as fortunate. So I definitely appreciate that. But what people think about Minnesota is they think like a lot of white people, and they think like, you know, it's super racist up there and things like that. And there's no Black people. They're always like, oh, you're from Minnesota. You know, is there any Black people out there? I'm like, yeah, obviously I was out there, so there had to be others out there. I think that Minnesota is a great place to grow up. The education is amazing. The people there are respectful and opening and things like that. They have this thing called Minnesota Nice, and basically what that means is people are being fake. You know, but they're super helpful. You know, you see them in the grocery store, like, hey, how you doing, buddy? And things like that. And it's just like, okay. But people go out of their way to make those kind of connections and conversations. I think as far as like racism goes, it's more so, it's discreet. It's not as openly as racist. It's more so like if you wanted a job or something like that, they will probably cross you off if your name sounds too ghetto or something like that. It's those kind of things. It's not like you see them in the store and they're like, oh, nigger this, get out of the store. It's not like that. And so that's really what it's like growing up in Minnesota. So the George Floyd situation, once that broke out, Minnesota was in a frenzy. Like, we had enough. We were outside marching and protesting. I personally was outside of the DA's house protesting and things like that. We were out there until like 10 o'clock at night before things started getting violent. That was a very important moment for me to be out there, because I felt like I'm fighting for all of my kids and everybody else's kids and the next George Floyd and all of these things. And if we just keep sitting at home and just kind of letting this thing go through, because at some point, I think a lot of people can relate and say that they might have felt numb because it was just so common of another Black person being killed by an officer. So at what point are we going to go out there and risk our lives and say, hey, this isn't okay, this is why it's not okay, and put pressure on these people in order to make this change? And so that's why I felt like it was important for me to be out there and for me to be out there protesting. I was out there in front of that AutoZone that ended up getting burnt down and things like that. It was just a very hard time and very scary time, to be honest, but I still felt like I had to be there because that is just so important to me, to make sure people are treated fairly. Moving to Atlanta, I'm from Minnesota, and I moved to Atlanta in July, so just fairly recent. And I felt like Atlanta was just like the place to, you know, it's a Black Mecca, it's the gay Mecca, like, so I felt like this was a place for me to be my most open self and for people to accept, you know, my Blackness, my gayness and things like that without it being so critiqued and nitpicked, like, what is he doing? What is he wearing? It's more accepted here. And so I felt like, just come here, own it, own yourself and live your best. And so in the months preparing my move and things like that, you know, I'm getting jobs transferred and I'm calling down here to try to make connects and network and things like that before I come down here. And so far it's been smooth. So in a very strange way, my biggest inspiration is Sierra. So Sierra inspired my whole music journey back when I was like super young. So I had to be, let's see, Goodies came out in 2004, so I was in the fourth grade. And I just loved her dancing, the hip-hopness of it all, the crunk, the energetic thing about it all. And so I started like playing with music. I was like remixing songs and making it about burgers. So like that Weird Al stuff, that was what I was doing when I was younger. And so eventually I got serious about it back in 2012, and I started writing actual like music and going to the studio and things like that. And so that was how the whole music thing started. And I felt like this was a way to get me like out of there. And I say it's weird that Sierra is my influence because she's a singer and I'm a rapper, but she started my musical journey and the journey of me like dancing and things like that. That's what really gets me going. As far as the Blacc Phoenix name, Blacc Phoenix, if it's broken down, it's really simple. Black was just because like I want to empower Black people, and I feel empowered by being Black, and there's meaning behind being Black. And then the two C's, so the C after that is just Cameron, and Cameron's my first name, my legal name, so if y'all see me on the streets, you can call me Cameron too. And Phoenix is because of the life that I've lived, right? My life has been a little hard, and I've had to overcome a lot of obstacles. And so being that I've overcome a lot of obstacles, the Phoenix rises from the ashes, and I've been torn down a lot and beat down and beat down. So a time that I had to overcome something like super challenging was me, and so my mother was a single mother and things like that. So she had to raise two kids on her own, and that was very hard in itself. But at some point, you know, we came to a huge disagreement. We could not really come and be aligned as that family unison. And at some point, I had to leave her house, and I was forced to live on the street, right? And so when I say the streets, like I was literally sleeping in my car kind of thing. And that was a very challenging time. I mean, because you're talking about Minnesota and the winters there are definitely brutal. So we're talking about negative 20 degree weather, sleeping in a car, having to turn it on and off every so often, right, to preserve gas, but also keep it heated so it's still heated, right? And so that was a very hard time. You know, I had to reach out to resources and things like that. And luckily there was a lot of resources for LGBT youth to come up, right? So this happened to me when I was 17 years old. And so there was a lot of resources that I was able to use in when I was 17. And then also after that, shortly after, I was able to get my first apartment at 18. And then ever since then, I never looked back because I was always just hustling on my own. Because I'm like, if you don't have, you know, yourself, then you have nobody. So just get it on your own. And so, I mean, I think that was a very challenging situation. Excuse me. That was a challenging situation, and that was how I rose from the ashes. Things like that. That's why I call myself Phoenix, right? Because it's just empowerment and empowering yourself to overcome your obstacles. I think the pros and cons to being a open gay rapper is that you can be yourself, you can explore, and then you can also educate others, right? So you can educate, you know, your peers, and sometimes, you know, that's other gays, but then also it's straight rappers as well, right? Because the gay community, or I'm sorry, the hip-hop community can be so homophobic and so damaging and things like that. Trying to break that wall down is so, excuse me, it is so fulfilling, but it is also so hard to do and so damaging to do. It takes a very strong person to do that. And so I think that that's one of the pros is that, yes, you know, I'm here to tear the wall down and be myself and live my best, right? But then also the con is that, you know, I'm also just looked at because, oh, he's gay and he got bars, but he has to go this hard so then he can be on our level. And it's like, but the straight rappers who are rapping also don't go as hard. Like the hetero male rappers just don't. You know, they don't go as hard or things like that. They don't have to. And so I think that's one of the cons about being a gay rapper is just that you're looked at for being gay, not your talent. So in my latest video this time around, it's, you know, hard lyrics. It's, you know, reclaiming your time. It's going in for what you want, right? So I'm talking about, you know, I'm not taking no for an answer. I talk about that I'm not taking no niggas back and things like that. It's about empowering yourself. And so when I say that, I talk about things like your booty hole has more users than IG and stuff like that. And so I'm really out there with the lyrics, but I say that because, again, like, the hetero male rappers can say whatever they want to say. The hetero female rappers can say what they want to say, or even just any female rapper can say what they want to say. And so just exploring, like, your sexuality and all of that shouldn't really be, you shouldn't have to skew away from that because I'm a gay male. I should be able to talk about whatever I want to talk about. I think that people that make out all black gay artists or even like dancers or anybody as characters just because you're, you know, rapping about your sex or you're rapping about just being who you are, I think is honestly ridiculous, right? You as an artist share the art with the people. And so whatever that art is, that is what you should be showing to the people. And, you know, people either need to accept it or they need to just move on, right? Because that is their story. Everybody else has a different story. Everybody's personality is different. And I mean, I think that's just, it is what it is. And as far as people being a critic of things, because I've gotten backlash before from my videos, because of course, you know, the hetero community will come in and oftentimes it's our black people that come to my comments and say the worst things about sinning and about, oh, you know, we're in our last days and things like that. And it's like, all I did was dance. I don't know how this is all of a sudden us living in our last days. But when I get those type of people, I just ignore it, honestly. I might clap back here and there just for shits and giggles. But other than that, I'm not really entertaining the negativity. The what inspired this time around is the last relationship that I went through. The last relationship that I went through was such a shit show. I mean, that guy put me through so much. I mean, I ended up having to like fight his ex-boyfriend and all of that. It was very, very stupid. And so I said, all right, this time, these are all the things I want. This is everything that I want. And it, all the people that hate, that talk shit online, that all of that shit, they're about to get exposed in this song. I'm going in. I'm going to say whatever I want to say. I'm talking about people's straight man. I'm talking about how they man still want me and all this other stuff. I'm going to say whatever I want to say. And it is, it's going to be what it's going to be. And if you don't like it, then your body get outlined in chalk. The lesson that I got out of the last relationship is do your fucking research. You know, do your research. Honestly, take your time. Take your time in relationships, because it's so easy to just go fast and you get that first connection that you haven't gotten in a long time or that you've never gotten. But you start missing those red flags. You start missing those red flags. And honestly, in my last relationship, I was going so fast. Like, I'm literally the Flash. And I was just missing this red light and this stop sign. And so at that point, you know, when I found everything out, it was way too late for me. And that was how I ended up in the shitty situation that I was in. The guy was still talking to his ex and things like that. And so it's like, but had I been paying attention, I would have probably seen those signs. And then I would have known to pull out beforehand. So Blackwashed, my EP, is available now. It is available for stream everywhere. You can stream it on Spotify, Apple, Tidal, everywhere, right? It's Black, B-L-A-C-C, Washed. That is everywhere. You can go ahead and Google it. I would say what's next for me is I'm going to continue to do shows here. It looks like everything is opening up, you know, due to the pandemic. So I'm excited for more clubs and things to start booking artists and stuff like that again. So you will see me soon. Please follow me on Instagram at Black, B-L-A-C-C, underscore Phoenix. All right. That is Black underscore Phoenix. If I can go back to my younger self and give my younger self some advice, I would say be humble and be respectful of your elders. I would say, you know, be humble and focus on what your goals are and go hard. Stop procrastinating. Stop procrastinating, younger self. And that's what I would say. I'm Black Phoenix and this is my story and I'm sticking to it. I'm out.
Niggas need to quit testing my patience before I make you Meredith's great patient. Dick in your mouth, so it's fuck what you saying. No, I'm not JC, but yes, I rock patience. Yo, booty hoe got more users than IG. Gay, stop exposing these DL athletes. Fucking up your coin, running your mouth like a track.